name's Max Rogers, I'm the Executive Director of the Neurological Alliance. I'm going to hand over very quickly now to Dr. Niall Pender, the President of Brain Health, and enjoy your report. Thank you.
Good morning. Thank you all for coming today. It's great to see such huge numbers, and it's great to have to change the venue today because of the interest in this field. It's something that we're delighted to see happening. I only have to speak to you for a very few moments, just to a few thank yous, I suppose. I'm going to start by thanking our very distinguished panel of speakers that we have today. They've given up their time. These are very busy people, and I'm very grateful for their time coming to talk to us this morning. I'm also very grateful to our colleagues in the European Brain Council who've come over to talk to us. They've been very supportive of the Irish Brain Council in the last few years, and we really appreciate that. Thanks also to Novartis for helping us today and for sponsoring this event. And I'd also particularly like to thank Max Rogers for organising and all the work she has done in being able to support the event today. So very briefly, the Irish Brain Council is a representative organisation of bodies that are interested in promoting brain health and brain research in Ireland. We have worked very closely with our European colleagues, and we're with the aim of promoting quality of life for people living with brain conditions in Ireland. We began by having a mission, as you can see here, to promote brain research, but as is entirely appropriate over the last few years, we broadened that to promoting brain health and promoting a clinical strategy in Ireland for developing clinical services for people with brain conditions. Our sole aim really is to try and improve the quality of life, services, the care, and the treatment of patients with brain conditions. Hopefully have a single strategy for all patients across the island where we can begin to understand and treat patients with complex brain conditions. Last year at our inaugural conference, this week produced and launched a position paper outlining the points that we want to achieve from the Irish Brain Council. I think you're going to be circulated with a link to this as part of your attendance today, and there are some spare copies floating around as well. So hopefully you get a chance to see this, read this, and take this on board, and we're looking forward to collaborating with more people, more organisations, with the aim of developing these services and improving the quality of life of people with brain conditions. So, without further ado, I will say...
So, one of the key functions of the Irish Brain Council has been to promote and support neuroscience research in the country. For the next session, which is our research focus session, we're going to have three speakers who are and have been at the forefront of neuroscience research in Ireland. First speaker is going to be Professor Ben Kenchel from RCSI, who is Professor of Molecular Physiology and Neuroscience. He's also Director of the Future Neuro Centre, which we've heard a little bit about. So.
Thank you very much. Good morning, everybody. I've been asked to speak for about 20 minutes on Future Neuro, which you've already had a brief introduction to. This is a new Science Foundation Ireland-funded research centre, which is focused on bringing scientific and technological solutions to chronic and rare neurological diseases here in Ireland. Before I talk about the centre, I actually want to just dial the clock back to 3 years, because it'll give you a bit of perspective on where the centre came from and where the sort of the planning and the origins. So the Neurological Alliance of Ireland, along with the Irish Brain Council and Novartis, put together a conference basically 3 years ago today in 2015. And the focus of that conference was to bring together various stakeholders in Ireland, so researchers at universities, clinician scientists, and some of the charity groups, to really address funding of brain research in Ireland, to identify where people felt were gaps, where there was needs, and how to move that forward. And out of that meeting came a policy document. And often a lot of meetings happen, and policy documents come about, and they sit there and nothing happens. But this, some of the conclusions of the policy document really stuck with myself and with several of the members of the audience here, including Warren Hardiman, and really laid the seed of what has eventually led to the development of a research centre. I picked out just a couple of the action points from this policy document, because the Future Neuro Centre, while it's not a panacea for all brain research in Ireland, it is going to tick some important and significant boxes. So one of the challenges was around drawing in new funding for brain research, and that there was a need for that, and that we had to make a case to relevant organisations like Science Foundation Ireland. The diversification, so that we shouldn't sort of just focus on single funding pots, but look and be creative about the way that we think about how to get brain research funded in Ireland, and that would include going to industry and pushing our research out to industry to secure that as funding. And one of the other points which I think is important, that we all felt that too many of the research grants that we get are 2 to 3 year terms, and it's very difficult to build momentum and create something important. And so that we ought to go after longer term strategic investments. And the Science Foundation Ireland Research Centres allow that type of long-term support to be put in place. So this is a brief introductory slide to Future Neuro, which, as mentioned, is going to focus on science and technology solutions for chronic and rare neurological diseases within the areas of diagnostics, therapeutics, and electronic and digital health. So what I'm going to try and do in the next 15 minutes or so is go through and answer the following questions. So first of all, what is a research center? Mark Ferguson has covered this topic, so I can go over that fairly quickly. Give an overview of the scientific and technology objectives of the center, a little bit about what we are going to focus on. Give some top-level, higher-level view of where we hope the center's research will impact, both economically and in terms of society and health. And finally, a little bit on where we are now currently. So the center was officially funded from October the 1st, 2017. What have we done over the last few months? So Science Foundation Ireland research centers are large, strategically important clusters of researchers across several different universities. There are 17 of these. Future Neuro was one of the ones funded most recently. So planning for this began just at the end, really, of 2015. The call for new research center ideas was launched in 2016. Here at RCSI, there are a number of neuroscientists, and we've been working for many years with clinical collaborators, particularly at Beaumont Hospital. And we realized that there was an opportunity to address important clinical challenges and scientific questions through the research center funding mechanism. This is quite a protracted and significant investment of time, so it's about a year and a half from when the expression of interest was invited all the way through to successful funding, which began in October, as mentioned. And the recipe for a successful center is to bring together interdisciplinary teams around a strategic goal that has potential societal and economic impact. To have an extremely strong principal investigator group, and then the really, really key ingredient here is that a third of your budget has to come through industry collaborations. So what this means is that the engine within the center has to be translational and applied research. But it does not exclude fundamental and basic research. And our research center includes both these ingredients. So I probably, for this audience, don't need to make too much of a point about the importance of brain diseases and the cost on society, which is estimated at around 3 billion euro. It's thought that around 700,000 people have a neurological condition in Ireland. Epilepsy and motor neuron disease are the two diseases that the centre is going to be focusing on initially. Epilepsy is an example of a chronic neurological disorder which can affect people of all ages, characterized by seizures. And motor neuron disease is a rare disease. It's a progressive, fatal neurodegeneration. What both these diseases share in common, and in fact what is true for most brain diseases really, is that we have two major and unmet needs, and these are around diagnosis and therapy. So for diagnosis, we are still heavily reliant on clinical history, clinical examination. But tools such as brain imaging and now genetics are becoming more and more part of the diagnostic process. But this will increase over time as genetic sequencing becomes more mainstream, but there are still challenges with bringing this into routine clinical practice. We also know that there are molecules that we may be able to detect within the blood, which are released from the brain, and that can also support diagnosis of neurological diseases. In terms of therapy for a disease like epilepsy, we have about 20 drugs for epilepsy, but a third of patients still remain drug resistant. They continue to have seizures, and none of the treatments we have are disease modifying. For motor neuron disease, there is simply no therapy. So these are two major challenges. And then the third idea behind the Future Neuro Center is around an opportunity in digital health and electronic healthcare. So our hospitals are now beginning to digitize electronic records, and we have one of the world's first national disease-specific electronic record for epilepsy. There's around 10,000 patients now with epilepsy whose records are now digitized, which includes all their imaging data, and soon will include genetics data. So what Future Neuro aims to do is to advance and accelerate genetic diagnosis into clinical testing, to develop and deploy biomarkers that can help with diagnosis in the area of therapy, to develop disease-modifying treatments that work in different ways from the current therapies, or to develop new therapies for diseases such as motor neuron disease, which don't currently exist. And then finally, use this digital electronic healthcare system that we have emerging in Ireland within our hospitals to create something that's really research-enabled, that can help, for example, with clinical trials. Because if you can identify every patient in Ireland with a particular mutation at the click of a button, you may be able to make Ireland a much more attractive place to conduct clinical trials for neurological diseases in the future. So that's the background to the center's research and our focus. I'm going to move now to introduce the members of the applicant group. So this is the core engine of the Future Neuro Research Center. The three of the principal investigators are based at my institute, RCSI. In addition to myself, there's Jochen Prehn, who's worked on motor neuron disease himself, as well as applying computational approaches to discover new drug targets. And Giampiero Cavalleri, who's a geneticist, who's also done pioneering work in identifying genetic sequences which predict adverse drug reactions to certain treatments. We have three principal investigators based at Trinity College Dublin. Paula Hardiman, who's a world authority on motor neuron disease, patients, care, and causes. Matt Campbell, who's an expert on blood-brain barrier. And this is important because some of the drugs that we think may be disease-modifying are big, bulky molecules that are difficult to get into the brain currently, and if we're going to get those into patients, we need to start thinking now and planning now for how those molecules can get into the brain. And Colin Doherty is another clinical neurologist and also based at Trinity, who's also an expert in epilepsy and the National Clinical Reference. Sam Bing-Shen, who's based at NUI Galway, he introduced the technology in Ireland to convert skin cells, fibroblasts, into different brain cell types, and he's going to be able to provide a set of models, cellular models of these neurological diseases. And finally, Robert Forster, he's a materials chemist based at DCU, who's developed technology to detect some of these new exotic molecules that we know get released from the brain in certain neurological diseases. If we're going to turn these into point-of-care devices, need people like Robert to develop the little detectors for these molecules. In addition to this PI group, we have a very important set of collaborators. These are clinicians based at the hospitals working with patients, and we also have funded investigators based at a number of the other institutes in Ireland that are supporting the research. Since we got funding, we also, within that funding unit, have support for an operations team. This includes a center manager, business development, operations officer, and education and outreach. And one of the important remits for any Science Foundation Ireland research center is an active and engaged education and outreach component. So we have Linda Coyne here, who's in the audience, who's been developing this program at the moment. We've already launched the Future Neuro website. We've also become very active on social media already, and I can tell you, having run a European project, that we've already got about twice the number of people following us, which is really a testament to how active Linda's been already with this. As this program grows, we plan to introduce more work around schools, and I'm going to talk just at the end about our education outreach objectives. Moving now to the structure of the research program, this is a high-level overview. And as mentioned, there's two basic types of research within one of these research centers. So we have what we call platform research. This is mainly PhD student-driven, open discovery science, which is aligned with the overarching objectives of the center. So these are PhD student projects which are not tied to industry interests, but would nevertheless, if they're successful, be interesting and relevant to the industry partners that we have. Then we have a series of projects which are co-funded or fully funded by industry partners. A couple of these have now signed and already began to fund research, so we can mention a couple of those names here, and one or two of the other industry partners have not yet signed, so unfortunately I'm not able to disclose them today. So just going through a little bit of detail, I won't get into much detail about the actual research, but in the area of diagnosis, as mentioned already, one of the questions that we have is, can we introduce more genetic testing to provide diagnosis for patients that are otherwise currently unable to know why they have a particular disease? Taking the example of epilepsy, we now know that there are several mutations which cause epilepsy where a specific drug will stop them having seizures. And so if you can identify that mutation, you can put them on a proper drug that is sort of specific or tailored for that particular patient. If we can identify some simple molecular biomarkers within the blood in patients or maybe other fluids such as cerebrospinal fluid in the brain, we may be able to also accelerate diagnosis. And we've identified some molecules in our own research and through our collaborations which can potentially tell the difference between a patient who has epilepsy versus another neurological disease. What we'd like to do is now begin to move these towards clinical testing and eventual commercialization. In therapeutics, we know that if we can develop cellular models of some of these novel patient mutations, we may be able to screen existing drugs and repurpose existing drugs for those patients. So we call kind of precision therapy approaches. We also know that many neurological diseases are not the result of a single genetic mutation, and that they may be thought of more as network diseases, where there are multiple changes within the brain contributing to the disease. So changes in neuronal function, glial function, and inflammation. And so maybe we need different types of molecules to target those diseases. And one of the areas that we're working on is what we call network targeting molecules, where the molecule itself has effects on a set of genes rather than a single gene. But some of these molecules are very big, and as mentioned, we're going to need to think already about how to deploy these. These won't be simple molecules that you can probably take as a pill, so we need to build in research that will allow us to overcome those challenges as they arise. And finally, in the third area around electronic health, what we want to do is create a more research-enabled electronic record that will allow us to input genetic information to continuously reappraise genetic information, because as we make discoveries about links between specific genes and neurological diseases, we may be able to go back to a patient's record and identify a new treatment in the future. We also see an opportunity to create more disease-specific electronic records for other neurological diseases, and taking the example of the registry that's been running for motor neuron disease patients by Iowa Parliament, create registries for other neurological diseases, powerful enablers of research. And finally, take advantage of some of the advances in computing, deep learning techniques, which can look through dense, complex clinical data and perhaps provide additional diagnostic support. Future Neuro is also underpinned by a number of technologies which have been put in place in the different institutions through previous funding rounds and equipment awards. So we have three basic areas around genetic diagnosis and pathway discovery, preclinical disease phenotyping. So we have a battery of animal models of these diseases, and also, of course, our clinical infrastructure in the different universities. These are just some of the examples of the areas where the Future Neuro Center is particularly strong. As mentioned, we've signed two of our industry partners, or at least we can disclose two of our industry partners. A third industry partner has also recently signed with a large investment in research around therapeutics, and we should be able to make an announcement about that shortly. To give you an idea of the spread of these companies, Congenica is a UK-based spin-out from Cambridge University, which has developed a software platform to allow clinicians to go through genetic data to make a diagnosis, and what they want to do is add on a new software package which will be specifically tailored to diagnosis of epilepsy. Greenlight is an Irish startup company focused on cannabis-based medicines. In the last couple of years, there's been a breakthrough in terms of cannabidiol, which is one of the plant-based compounds in cannabis, for the treatment of rare severe epilepsies. And this is an area where there will be a number of additional opportunities, both in the field of epilepsy, but also in other disorders like multiple sclerosis, perhaps in pain research. And we also have companies aligned in the electronic health record, which again, we haven't yet been able to disclose. So we're going to move on to some of the higher level socioeconomic impacts that we hope to see from the research center. I'll start with this slide, which is a very optimistic but hopefully deliverable change that Future Neuro can make towards the patient journey. So as a result of the research within the centre, as a result of some of the technological outputs, we hope to be able to improve the patient journey. And this is an overview of how that might happen. So in the near future, and this is actually already happening, patients that are newly diagnosed or with a suspected diagnosis of a disease such as epilepsy may come in, they'll have a blood sample taken, and their information will be entered on a digital electronic record specific for that disease. The genetic analysis may point to a specific cause of their disease, which for many patients is an enormously valuable piece of information, but it may also lead them, the doctor, to the choice of a specific therapy. They may also have a biomarker profile taken where we look for specific circulating molecules other than DNA that may support a diagnosis. Where there is no clear genetic cause, that patient may be suitable for one of these network targeting molecules, which are not yet in clinical use, but through working with some of the partners that we have in the center, we may be able to move those patients into clinical trials, which would be enabled by the fact that we could identify all of the patients with that particular condition nationally. Another ambition for the centre is to bring together the various clinicians working with patients with neurological diseases in Ireland to streamline, to facilitate clinical trials and additional testing across both the pediatric and adult neurological disease area. We have obviously ambitious PhD training plans within the centre. We have an initial intake of 10 PhDs across the different institutes within Future Neuro, and this will grow in subsequent years. Some of the features of our training programme within Future Neuro will include placements and opportunities for those students to spend time in the clinical setting so that they get exposed to the real world environment of what a clinician treating a patient with a neurological disease is challenged with. We also have commitments from our industry partners to host these PhD students for periods of time within their companies, and this is spanning from startup companies all the way through to multinational companies. And we hope that Future Neuro can continue the fantastic work of our clinician scientists in informing national policy. And an example recently was Colin Dougherty, who was involved in putting forward the argument for access to medical cannabis the treatment of certain neurological diseases. Then finally, we have our education and outreach program, which is being led by Giampiero Cavallari with Linda Coyne, part of our operations team, who which has four main focuses. The first of these is around improving understanding and contributing to reducing the stigma associated with neurological diseases, increasing the engagement of patients and lay people in the direction of research to try and incorporate more research that is focused around patient objectives in addition to scientifically driven ones, to support particularly disadvantaged schools in terms of going out to these schools, talking to the school kids, and encouraging scientific careers, and finally contributing to best practice among clinical teams and research nurses. So finally, just a slide on where we are since funding was initiated back in October. So the award from Science Foundation Ireland is a fraction under 8 million euro. We then have an additional around 3 million euro committed from industry partners. The centre began October 1st. We've recruited just over half of the initial intake of PhD students. We should be continuing with the second half of those in the next month or two. We've signed three of our six initial industry partner contracts, which is already 1.28 million euro in industry cash for the centre. And we've also already made roads on our social media website up and running. And all of our initial intake of PhD students have gone into the Trinity College Innovation Training Academy, which is a postgraduate certificate in innovation and entrepreneurship, so that these students are focusing not just on their own research projects, but thinking about being creative and innovative into the future. So thank you very much.